My name is Edita Klimyte, and I'm in Becky Dutch's lab, and I'm an MD-PhD student. So I'm actually from Lithuania, and I moved to the United States when I was about 8, and I grew up in the Chicagoland area. I think a lot of it had to do with my mom. She did all of her education to become a pharmacist in the U.S., actually outside of formal coursework, so she would just buy the books and study at home while she was still working a full-time job. I just basically grew up with my mom using all of her free time to further her education for her career. And so that just kind of became the norm. As far as I can remember, I always wanted to be a doctor. That's just something that I was always interested in. And then when I was an undergraduate at Michigan State University, I got involved in research and just really enjoy it. So I actually had a very dual experience in college in that it was both really science heavy with pre-med courses, as well as I worked in a lab all 4 years of undergraduate. But I also got a degree in Spanish literature and language. And so I had both an arts focus as well as heavy science and research, which I really enjoyed that balance. The science was really what, you know, won me over. And I really liked my lab experiences. Things can change very dramatically on what field you're studying, what techniques you're doing, and who you're working with. And I think that's what makes it so exciting. When you have protocols that go on many days, a single mistake can actually mess up the entire experiment. And so you have to really pay a lot of attention to detail. And then also, you know, even if you do mess up and you just lost a couple of days worth of work, be willing to come back the next day and do it again and try again. But when it does work and you get that really nice image or really nice gel or really clean data, it's very rewarding when you finally can accomplish that. Right now, as I'm getting really close to graduating, I'm really focused on finishing my final experiments and actually writing papers. So my dissertation project involves human metapneumovirus, which is a respiratory virus that was discovered about 15 years ago now, and we realize that it infects everyone worldwide. So my specific project is looking at the interaction between the viral particle, so HMPV, and the target cells that this viral particle is trying to infect. And so Becky's group, they discovered that there's a very specific type of sugar that is on the target cell that the virus is trying to infect, that the virus needs in order to be able to bind to it. So the virus needs the sugar. So how can we disrupt that interaction between the viral particle and the target cell? And so I have several different approaches on how to do this, and I'm basically assessing how effective they are in multiple models. So using some complex 3D models, which are basically resemble very closely to what our lungs look like. So they're basically tiny slivers of tissue that look just like human lung tissues. So I think as a basic scientist that does bench science, it's really exciting to know that some of the things that I'm working in my system with this particular virus actually has potential to eventually lead to developments that could influence therapeutics in people. So before my interview day for the MD-PhD program, I'd actually never been to the state of Kentucky. And within that one day, being here and meeting everyone convinced me to come here. The main thing that got to me that set it apart is everyone is extremely down to earth and very oriented towards teamwork and collaboration. And that's definitely come true in the 6 years now that I've been here, is the people are very accomplished and making great strides in science and medicine. However, they are very down to earth and offer many things outside of just, you know, professional collaboration, such as friendship and mentorship and teamwork day to day.
Thank you.